Hi, this is Sheshanand. Welcome to Aerotech Solutions. Today I want to give one more application using microcontroller. Date and time display using microcontroller and 7 segment combination. So you can subscribe us from YouTube with the channel Aerotech Solutions and also like from Facebook Aerotech Solutions. So this application is very clear. It just displays time and date on multiple 7 segment display. So most of the digital clocks, they designed with multiple 7 segment displays. They are more effective and you can watch any digits from long distance. The reason behind using these 7 segments is very clear. So they will work with high contrast. Especially for digit displays, they are going to prefer these 7 segments in most of the products. Okay, so this is just simple view of application with block. It contains just 3 individual blocks as power supply and microcontroller and one multiple 7 segment digit section. Whereas power supply used for converting AC to DC. Because microcontroller and other units require DC power source, so that you need to design one power supply unit along with application. So this power supply unit contains the internal parts as rectifiers which converts AC to DC, but it is not pure DC. So again you have to use filter section and regulator section. Finally you can take your fixed DC source from regulators. And microcontroller, this microcontroller unit again contains some standard connections, one crystal oscillator, whereas reset circuit components are mandatory for your device. Now you can connect your multiple 7 segments with microcontroller I/O ports. I'll show you the circuit how I connected these multiple 7 segments with microcontroller. So this is my hardware connection with a 6 digit multiple 7 segment. So whereas A, B, C, D, E, F, G and DP, which is dot pointer. These 8 data lines I connected with one complete port from microcontroller. Whereas 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are common pins. The 7 segment deals with 2 types of devices, common anode and common cathode. Whereas common anode needs logic 1 for common pins. So these common pins you need to manage with your programming. So whenever you are activating first common pin and whatever the data you are assigning across A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, it allows to display on first segment. And whenever you are trying to display the other digit on second one, then you have to disable this first common pin and you have to activate your second common pin. And how multiple 7 segment manages different numbers with common data lines just by switching this common pin with very less time delay in program. That's where response time is one more important parameter for display devices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are common pins. With your programming, you have to manage these common pins. At a time, only one common pin you need to switch. If you are activating other common pins, there is a mix of data on these 7 segments. Okay, so if you are trying to display different numbers, just manage your common pins. So these common pins you have to program in a very clear way, then only you will get proper displays on 7 segment. Okay, so we'll go for logic, so which is developed in Keil IDE. So I developed already this embedded C program for this date and time display. I'll show you this program and I'll explain line by line. So Yes. Now this is my text, what application I am trying to develop, and this is my header file. You need to include reg51.h for all 51 families so that it supports to use all SFR register names in program without any declaration. From hardware circuit, whatever the pins you are connecting across microcontroller GPIOs, you have to define with the help of SBit data type. SBit is a single bit data type which helps to use one GPIO or to access one single bit from any SFR register, but it should be bit addressable register. Bit addressable means it allows to access one single bit from entire SFR register. Whereas IO ports are all over bit addressable. You can access individual IOs by using these common pins. So now I am trying to use six common pins for six individual. These are six common pins connected with six IO pins from microcontroller. And one delay function I am taking here. And main logic starts from here. This is user defined delay function. Now, so I am taking one temporary variable V1, and the initial status of IO pins I am assigning logic zeros. This is infinite loop while of 1. Now I am taking first for loop to display date up to some particular time. So this for loop allows to display today's date with up to some time. So just by repeating and executing same lines some 200 times, so it allows to print date sometime on 6 digits. Just see here how I am handling these common pins of 7 segment. The first common pin I am activating with this logic 1. While activating first common pin, you have to assign the data across these data lines. So you have to calculate common anode and common cathode values. The common anode values, just by giving common pin to VCC, and if you are looking to turn on the segment, you have to assign logic 0. As per that, you have to get these hexadecimal values for your proper numbers. So you have to follow lookup table for common anode and common cathode values. The lookup table you have to prepare yourself up to for A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. As per expected number, you have to run on logic zeros for common anode case. Now I am using common anode in this application. For display 2, I will get EA4 is my hexadecimal value. And I am calling this user defined function delay. Let's see the definition of delay function here. This delay function, which gives some microseconds time delay, and after microseconds time delay, again I am activating second common pin, but before that first common pin logic should be 0, because data lines are common. You have to manage your only common pins in programming. The second digit I am expecting number 9 with dot pointer on. So this is the equivalent value of 9 with dot, and then delay. And the third common pin I am activating, and I am assigning equivalent data. So now today's date is 29/05/2020. So this is my expected output on 6 digit multiple 7 segment. But each time you have to activate only one common pin. First disable your previous common pin and activate your next common pin and process your data. So because of this for loop, it allows to execute some time. And again compilation shift to the second for loop, but the second for loop, what I am expecting time with the hours and minutes. So time value is quite different than date. So as per this application, I am displaying just present time. You can continue just by calling exact time delays between second, minute and hours. So this for time loop and this for loop for date. So this is a simple embedded C program with different values just by managing this common pin. I'll show you this hardware output for this application, which is designed in Proteus. So the Proteus is a simulation tool which helps to design hardware circuits and also check the outputs. So this is my hardware design with Proteus simulation tool. Is the most familiar simulation tool for all electronics engineers. You can link your hex file of your equivalent embedded C program with this option. Now link your hex file and play your simulation. Now this is date and later it changes to time. Date and time. Simultaneously, this application allows to display date and time by using 6-digit common ANO display. This is a simple application by using multiple 7-segment displays. For more videos, please subscribe our channel from YouTube/Eritech Solutions. And we are giving online trainings, classroom trainings, and we are into placement support who have completed embedded system course, and we are doing applications for small scale companies. We are into development and projects. We support to do academic projects also. For any requirement on embedded system, please get back with this number 9676327118 on phone call or WhatsApp. And we are located in Hyderabad, KPHB, near KPHB Metro Station, Bhagyanagar Colony, Kukatpally. So please reach us with this contact number 9676327118, and any queries, please email us at ysnanda@eritechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.